Hi dear students, welcome to S&S Bio Info. Today's topic is respiration in lower animals. What is respiration? Simply, it's an action of breathing. Respiration is actually the biochemical process in which the cells of an organism obtain energy by combining oxygen and glucose, resulting in the release of carbon dioxide, water and energy. Now let's familiarize the respiratory organs of lower group of animals. First of all, general body surface. Number one, general body surface. Body surface. Some lower group of animals like porifera, coelenterata, flatworms, they respire through body surface by a process called simple diffusion. You know what is simple diffusion? It's the process of movement of particle from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. In such animals, the gaseous exchange takes place by simple diffusion. Oxygen is diffused into the body, then carbon dioxide is released out from the body. The next one is moist skin or cuticle. Second one, moist skin or cuticle. Some animals like earthworms have moist skin through which diffusion takes place. Oxygen is diffused into the body, carbon dioxide is released out. The third one is tracheae or tracheal system. Tracheae or tracheal system. Tracheal system. Tracheae are the network of tubes that helps in gaseous exchange in most of the insects. Oxygen is diffused into the body through the spiracles to the network of the body. That is the trachea or tracheal system in insects. Fourth one is gills. Gills. Gills are the specific respiratory organs of most of the invertebrates like aquatic arthropods, aquatic insects, mollusca, then hemichordata, etc. Some vertebrates also possess gills like fish and also the tadpoles of frog. The fifth one is lungs. Lungs. Most of the land vertebrates such as birds, mammals and reptiles, they possess vascularized bag-like structures called lungs as their respiratory organs. Then let's recall the names of the respiratory organs of some animals. General body surface, the animals like porifera, coelenterata. Next, moist skin, earthworms, trachea or tracheal system, insects, gills, aquatic animals like aquatic arthropoda or aquatic insects, fish, etc. Lungs, all land vertebrates like reptiles, birds and mammals. Is it clear now? The next topic is breathing rate. Respiration involves two processes such as inhalation and exhalation. Inhalation and exhalation. Exhalation. Inhalation is the process of intake of oxygen-rich air into the body, while exhalation is the process of releasing out of carbon dioxide from the body. Do you know what is breathing rate? It is the total number of breath per minute. If you want to find out your breathing rate, you have to count your inhalation or exhalation. Either inhalation or exhalation. Then you can find out your breathing rate. Have you ever observed aquarium fish? How do they breathe? Do you know? They engulf the water through their mouth and it is washes over the gills. But they do breathe very fast. Why do they breathe so fast? Because they need oxygen that is dissolved in water. The amount of oxygen that is dissolved in water is comparatively lower than that of the oxygen present in the atmospheric air. So that aquatic animals need to breathe more faster than the terrestrial animals. Now let's learn about some common features of respiratory organs in animals. Number one, those animals possess specific structures of respiratory organ to increase the surface area for the maximum exchange of gases. First one, more surface area for what? Maximum exchange of gases. Second one, the surfaces are very thin and delicate. Surfaces thin and delicate. Thin and delicate. In order to protect the thin and delicate surfaces, those organs are placed within the body of animals. So third point, placed inside the body. The organs are placed inside the body of animals. Fourth one, there will be a specific passage to direct the air towards the site of exchange of gases. Okay, specific passage. They possess specific passage. Finally, there will be mechanism of moving air in and out of the area where exchange of gases take place. So, mechanism of moving air in and out of the area. So, these are some common features of the respiratory organs of animals. Just before I have told you that different animals possess different respiratory organs. For example, that fishes, they possess gills. Those gills are placed within the body because gills are delicate organ. They are vascularized organ. Those organs are richly supplied with blood vessels. Next one, lungs. Lungs in vertebrates, reptiles, birds and mammals, including human beings, they are placed within the body in order to protect the thin membrane of the exchange site, that is surface area of the lungs. Similarly, trachea in insects, those are also placed within the body of insects. With this, I conclude this session. I hope you understood what are the respiratory organs of various organisms, breathing rate, the common features of respiratory organs in animals. Thank you and have a nice time.